Hello everyone, welcome back to GK Code Labs. So a few days back, I have promised you that I'll be adding a few use cases, few real-time big data use cases to my Trello board, to all of the members who are already subscribed to my extended plan. They'll be able to see that and see what the use cases are and try to implement. But for some reason, I was not able to do that. But recently, I have added three new use cases, and actually the use cases is one, but how to distribute all that into the actual project structure, everything I have added in detail in my Trello board. So in this video, I'll be telling you what all I have added, and telling you a little bit in detail that what actually you have to do, maybe in case you are an extended plan member and you I'm not sure what that means. So I'll be clarifying everything so that you can be sure of what is required in those use cases, and you can go ahead and develop them. This use case is the real-time use case that I have been once exposed to. So I have to develop all this. So same thing, it's very interesting. So please watch this video till the end and see what the requirements are, and try to develop on your own. And in case you face any issue, just comment down in the comment section of this video. So let's go and check this use case out. So here we are back to our Trello board. I can see few people have already moved these cards to in progress, the previous cards, and the comments also I can see that completed Sridevi. So okay, some people have marked those as completed, but I still don't see any code in my GitHub. So I would request, if you are marking anything as completed, it's fine you are not moving that to completed, because other people might be attempting that. But if you have completed, I would request, as suggested earlier, please make a branch with your name and push that code as well, so that we can review, and maybe other people can also have benefits from that. So now, the product backlog. I have added three more cards which relate to one of our use cases. So let's see, let's go one by one, and I'll explain you what you have to do. So the first card says create fixed width converter. So in this scenario, our requirement is to ingest a fixed width file into our big data solution. So if you're not sure of what is a fixed width file, I'll tell you. So usually you must have seen a few file formats, like the normal file formats like TXT, JSON, or YML or YAML, and other non-readable formats as well, like ORC, Parquet, etc. So usually if you see, apart from YAML, we'll discuss it later, but Spark already has the APIs to read all these popular formats. But still there is one format, one file format that is readable, in fact, and still Spark doesn't support for most of the versions. That is a fixed width file, or you can say that as a positional file. So what is this? So this is a file format where the columns are defined as their limitation to certain characters in the file. So let's say I have employee ID in a file. So some employee ID, as someone has joined earlier, maybe 1, 2, 3. And down the line, 5 years later, there are many more employees, and the employee ID now lies between 5 characters. So it should be something like 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. So 6 characters it is, anyways, whatever, but different. Some other employee ID, maybe something more than that. And then lies the employee name, EMP. One, and let's say for this it is EMP 3, it is something EMP 4, something like that, anything. So in such cases there could be multiple entries, multiple columns, and the value of column can be
defined as the position of these characters. That's why they are known as fixed width or the positional files. So let's say I tell you that from 1 to 11. So from 1 to 11, whatever comes from till this character length, that is my employee ID. I'll say like that. And after that, from 11 till some specific thing, so till from here to here, be it your actual value is doesn't lie in that, your EMP ID. Let's say I tell you that from 11 till some 20 or something, that will be your employee name. But your employee name can be from this character, somewhere between this, but the length will be same. Something like that. So I hope you get it. What is the positional files? Why this is important in big data? I tell you that the mainframe files that generate the binary format of data. So in most of the use cases, those files are converted to fixed width, or there are some mainframe systems that itself give you the positional files or the fixed width file. And there are chances that most of the projects that you are going to or you are giving interview for will be using these kind of files. So it's very important to know, apart from ORC, like obviously that is not readable, but anyways you have the APIs to read that. But for such kind of file, there are very rare APIs where you have to code it yourself, that where to understand the columns, how to understand the rows and all. So that's why I have added this interesting use case to my Trello board. Let's see how many of you try to implement that, and we'll go through the code. And anyways, if I don't see any responses, I'll be explaining you how to do this. So let's go back to the Trello board and see what all is the actual requirement. So the fixed width converter. Now, I'm sure you know that what is a fixed width file. So this should be able to infer and filter the header from the given file. The header begins with the keyword head. So I'll sort of show you the sample file for this that is also now pushed to the GitHub. So this is our project, GK Collab project. And if you go inside this source main, inside the resources, you'll see fwsample1.txt. So this is the file, I just pushed it. So you'll have the sample of this. Let me show you how this file looks like. So don't go with this project name. This is another project of mine. But anyways, if you are an extended plan member and you have cloned this project, GK Collab project 1, I would suggest you open that again and go to VCS, Git, and do a pull. And you'll be getting inside your resources directory, you'll be getting this file, because in that project as well, I have pushed the same file. So this is a sample of that file. So let's understand. As I told, the header would start with the keyword head. That's what this says. So it should infer and filter the header from the given file. That means it should understand that anything that starts with head is the header of this file. It should infer and filter it out. How this filter will go ahead, let's see. Then eliminate all blank lines. So all this blank line you are seeing, it should eliminate it. Eliminate means it should not consider it. Then eliminate all blank spaces if at the beginning. So you can see in the sample, in the footer or in any record, if there is a blank space or multiple blank spaces, it should not consider that. Then eliminate all characters over 30 characters per line. So in case for any line, all the characters, in case they are going above 30 characters, it should not consider that. So visibly obvious that this would go over 30. So maybe I'll just give you a background idea. Maybe this is the name. We are not sure of that, but this is the name, then followed by maybe the phone number, and then the company it belongs to. So you can understand like that and make your schema according to that. And over 30 characters, anything that you have, you should not consider it. Maybe there is a use case that we don't need anything over that. So hope you get it. Then infer and filter the footer from the given file as it was given for header. The footer begins with the word foot. So you can see here foot, but there is a blank spaces that is already covered in above, like clear all blank spaces. Okay, then record the footer count given in the file into a variable. So footer count will be followed by foot keyword. So whatever is it given here, that will be your footer count, and you should save it into a variable. Okay, then return the passing records. So all that record that passed, that means it should not be the header, which you have already ignored. It should not be the footer, which you have already ignored. It should not be the blank lines, which you have already ignored. Whatever else is passing, it should return that. So I hope you get the idea. So this was the first function that you have to create. Now, create fixed width FW to DF converter. That means fixed width to data frame converter. Now, this should be able to read the passing records from fixed width converter, that was what we discussed previously, and convert them into Spark data frame, then return the data frame. So whatever records were there as per the given schema. I'm sorry, I think I forgot to mention the schema, so I'll mention it right here. Okay, convert the Spark data frame with schema as name, that should be of let's say 10 characters, then your phone, that should be of 10 characters again, and your company, that should be your 8 characters. So 10 plus 10, 20 and 8, so 28, and 28 will cover in this, and over 30 characters it should not consider anything. I'll save it. Okay, so schema also you have. Then return this data frame. Now, the third class that you have to make is third class or object you have to make is fixed width validator. What this has to do is take the data frame from FW to DF converter, the previous object, and validate the records as per below conditions. It has to validate something. What first thing is write the records to a directory if the footer value matches the actual record count. So like we saw here, so there are apparently two records here and foot two, you can say. So there are two, if the record count that you passed as a variable, if it matches this, then it should write the records to a directory. You can choose the directory of your choice, of your local system or wherever you are doing this, and throw a custom exception with message count mismatch. So how to throw custom exceptions, if you are not aware, there is already a video on our channel. You can click on the I button and see here. So the requirement is it should throw custom exception with a message as count mismatch and fail the workflow. Okay, so that is the basic requirement. And also I'll tell you how it should look like, how the end development should look like. So let's say I have this file and there are two records with Arpit as here saying 90 and something like that. If I run my workflow, obviously I'm not showing you the code because I expect you to develop it, but anyways, the end result I'll show you. If I run this, so you can see name is separated out, phone is separated out, and the company is also separated out, GKC comp2, and you see count is matching. I mean, these are just the print results that I wanted to show you. You need not do that. You have to write this to a file. And in case, let's say I change this footer record to 4, it has to also validate that is it matching with the actual count, but the records are 4, sorry, the records are 2 and the footer says 4. So now if I run it, it displays like whatever it was supposed to, but eventually it throws an exception, GKC exception. You can make your own class, like a GKC exception was already lying there, so I use the same, but the message that is main thing to focus, count mismatch, and it throws an exception. So that is what is required in this particular use case. So all my extended plan members who have access to this Trello board, please, I would request you, this is a weekend, go ahead, do this exercise. Let me know if you have any confusions.
So this was the use case, guys. And let me tell you, this is a very important use case, because if you go into a company where the company or the project is moving from a legacy system to a big data solution, but their ingestion system, the data that is generated from the servers, that still is kind of old school. There are majority of projects like that I have seen. So they will require you this particular use case. That is very important. So I'm sure if you go with this, attempting this, and let me know if you don't find a solution, I'll tell you. But if you go with this, and if at all that question is asked to you, that what challenges you have faced and how did you implement the fix with files, if you tell that you had this kind of requirement in your existing project, it will help you a lot. So try to attempt this, and please, all the extended plan members, if you do it, I see many of the cards you have commented on that it is completed. I would request you that you have already been given the access, so please comment your code. And please push that to the Git repository so that I can pull and I can see what solutions you have written, and we can discuss in such kind of. All the best. Please hit that like button if you like this video, and please subscribe to our channel if you have not already done. Thank you, guys. See you later.